In the early days of digital consoles, they used to be a little clunky, they didn't sound all that great, and they were pretty confusing to use. But all that has changed. Modern digital technology has made small digital consoles super affordable while keeping a solid functionality. Plus, they do all have the same fundamental concepts as analog, but with some additional features that help our workflow. In this video, to see some differences between analog and digital, we look at a few analog consoles and see how they scale in size and need outboard processing. We also look at digital consoles and talk about their small footprint and recallable settings. And finally, we discuss how an offline editor can help you learn the software for digital consoles. So looking at our little diagram here, it shows you the typical layout for a small format analog console, like this one made by Mackie. This has 12 input channels, 4 groups, and a main stereo output. And this size is great for many applications, and often this is all you need. But in larger productions, the size of the console grows depending on how many inputs we need for any particular show. And remember, each fader is dedicated to one input or one output, so more input capability means the real estate adds up quickly. This Midas XL4 has 48 channel strips along with an output section in the middle of the console, which is great, but it comes in at about 7 feet across. And when we look at equivalent digital consoles, even flagship models like this Digico SD7, they usually only come in about 5 feet, while the even more compact SD9 comes in at less than 4 feet. This console still handles 48 inputs, provides compressors and gates on every channel, and has a ton of options for effects. In addition to the larger surface area, the compressors, gates, and effects for analog consoles are outboard, which means they have to live in separate racks and take up even more space. This also requires physically patching cables between the console and the racks, which is more work than digital consoles and is the biggest drawback to analog setups. In live music these days, it's standard to see digital consoles at all levels of production. They do have pros and cons when compared to analog, but there is no question they've changed the workflow of live sound. And for more than any other reason, this is true because the settings of digital consoles can be saved and recalled later. Now, this allows me to do a show in New York, fly to Australia with a USB stick, and load my entire show in seconds. Or I could sound check 5 bands and then pull up their settings 100% accurately right before showtime without having to write anything down, which is not at all possible with analog. Now, there are cons to digital consoles, the biggest being that each one uses different software and has a different layout. This can present a steep learning curve, and if you're pressed for time during a show, this can be super stressful, believe me. Another difference between the two just comes down to sound quality. Like most things in audio, you do pretty much get what you pay for, but there's no real sonic substitution for a high-quality analog console. The latest generation of high-end digital consoles do sound really good. They sound fantastic, but they are quite expensive, and cheap digital consoles can sound a little thin. But for most people, a slight difference in audio quality is nothing compared to the workflow enhancements we get from digital. However, if you're interested in seeing how a particular digital console works, I highly recommend you take a look to see if it has an offline editor. This lets us run the software on a computer, which lets us build files or just play around and explore how everything is set up. Again, each digital mixing console is different, and this is just a great way to get familiar without actually having the console in front of you. In this video, we looked at both analog and digital consoles and talked about how using an offline editor can help you learn the software for a digital console.